Bellow Whovians and Torchwood fans, and welcome back to another Marvellous Figure Monday. I think this is our fifth one, and today we are reviewing the Torchwood figures. I do have to apologise how this video has been a bit late on doing it. I've just been very, very busy with stuff, life, schooling, but here we got it. We're doing it today on this Monday, so it's been put back 2 weeks, but it doesn't really matter, as here they are. I hope you enjoy the video. So here are the Torchwood Wave 1 figures. Now they are two waves, but this is the first wave. This is the Captain Jack, Brian Cooper, a Cyberwoman, and a Weevil. So, well, this wave came out, I don't know, but it came out during season 1 or season 2 or something like that. But they're not made by character options. They're slightly bigger and they come with a stand. So they are slightly bigger build. They are more 6-inch. I don't know. I'll show you comparison with Jack a bit later. But yeah, they look nice. But I'm going to just go through and review them individually. So here is Captain Jack Harkness, or whatever his real name is. So yeah. Played by John Barrowman, and here he is. He has articulation, like a little nod to each side. A full 360 on the arms, a 90 degree bend here. That there, 90 degree at the hips. None at the hips, and oh, that's it. So, articulation, it's decent. Nothing amazing, it's just decent. It's capable, it's nothing bad, nothing good, but it's just okay. Comes with his nice gun accessory, like all of them, and he does have actually a gun pouch, but you can't actually open it, so it's a bit pointless being there, but it gives it a bit more detail. He has different hair to his other one, but let me just compare him to the other Captain Jack from character options. So here is the other Captain Jack from character. As you can see, it's way smaller. But then even if I take this one off the stand, because the stand is removable. Oh, and the stand is a Torchwood T, which is quite nice, and they stand either side of the T. But even if I take them away, you can definitely see the height difference. This one's much, much taller than that one, and the hair's different, obviously. I probably actually like the scale of these better, because they've got a much bigger scale, and it gives them a bit more detail. They just look nice. I probably like this one. Probably like this one the best, just detail-wise, and I think they look really good together. Next up we have Gwen Cooper, and yeah, Eve Miles. So this is a nice figure. She comes with a gun accessory like Jack does. She has no articulation in the head because it's a very hair piece thing. She has full 360 in her arms, 90 degree bend here, 360 in her hand, yeah. Off the sand. She actually has articulation 360 there, 45 there, 90 degrees there, and yeah, that's it. So probably better than the other one. Accuracy, this one's much more accurate, I think, to what Captain Jack looks like in this Captain Jack looks, just because I think the facing actually looks really like from the TV show, from the episodes. She comes with her in a black jacket and a red top. Guns fired up. But I have to say, these guns, they actually sometimes slip out of their hands quite easily. They all are moulded to fit into this. What hand's that? This side hand, the left hand side hand. But they fall out. But if you position it right, you can actually get it in there. But I'm just going to leave it out. She has actually very, very thin legs for what she is. So if I can just stand her up there. Very, very thin. But she manages to stay up, which I like it because other figures, like Clara, as a good example, character option is Clara 1. She has very, very skinny legs and she doesn't stand up that well, but she actually stands up really easily. So yeah, I think for Gwen, that is really good figure and really good accuracy. So next up we have a Cyberwoman, or Lisa, I think she's called in the TV show. Yeah, Lisa. Yeah, again, she can remove off her stand. She does not come with any accessories, so don't think she can have any accessories, I don't know. So this is good if you've got a Cyberman collection, because if so, I'll get another Cyberman. They're actually good scale together, but let's focus on this one here. So she's a half-converted Cyberman, if I remember correctly. She comes with that same headpiece as she actually, what I find fascinating, it's a very, very, it's a very similar design to that one, a bit thinner though, and obviously you can see her face there. But I like this figure, it's very accurate to what she looks like, and she articulation, she can do a full 360 in the head, full 360 there, full 360 there, 90 there, full 360 there, actually 90 there, 90 there, and yeah, that's it. She does come with high heels, which is a nice thing to say about. I forgot to say also Gwen comes with high heels as well, but she comes with high heels, which might make her harder to stand up, but actually she surprisingly stands up, which this is what I love about these Torchwood figures, is actually they're actually quite sturdy and they stand up nicely. And yeah, I think this is a decent figure and a worthy one indeed. To finish off the wave one, here we have got the Weevil, a very common figure, if you know what I mean, if you've looked on eBay, because every single time you search up torture figures, half the results are, well, more than half the results are actually Weevils. I don't know why they're so common, maybe they release more, I don't know, but they're very, very common. He comes off the stand. You can have him in, like, what I like about him, you can actually have him like in a like a pose like that, which looks more Weevil like or if you just want to display him a bit nicer, a bit easier, you can just have him standing up like that. It's up to you. I don't care. But, he can do a little, you can actually do a 360 instead on that little ball joint thing. He can do a 360 there. He even do a 90 there, which is our first. You can do a 90 there. You can do an either 360 there. So he actually has lots of articulation because you can pose him in different places. He can, I'm sure he can actually do a, there you go. He can do a 360 there as well at the waist. 90 there, 90 there, and yeah. Also 90, no, 360 there. If you pull it tight enough, I mean it's quite loose to be honest, but you can't, it's actually quite tight, sorry, loose, tight, it's quite tight. It's a good Weevil, very, very common, don't know why it's common, but it's a good collection. So what do I overall think about Wave 1? Now, I like the designs of the figures, I think, especially that Gwen looks like her. Captain Jack could have had a bit better looking, but I don't know. They are the cheapest out of the two waves, definitely. You can get them from, usually they're like prices between £6 to £10, so they are easier to get from wave two are quite hard to get hands on in eBay. Like I said, I did buy these on eBay brand new, but so that's these wave one figures. They come all on the exact same stand. I don't know what else to say about them. They're a set of four, they look nice together. I'll talk about one thing actually. I'm going to talk about my other video, this the wave two, which will come soon. Wave two will come soon. But what I like to say is they never did an Owen figure. Now, that is really, really not nice because they did a jack and one in this one, and then the other wave they did a Tosh and Yonto, but they never did an Owen for some reason, which makes me go really mad because he's like the fifth member of the team, he's like the cherry on the cake, but no, they just never did a figure of him. But that's nothing to do with this wave. So what am I going to do now? Well, I'm going to do, you know it, I'm going to do that little story action pack thing, you know, that I did like two things ago, because this is our fifth one. This is my fifth Marvelous Figure Monday, so that's good, but we're going to do our little action story thing. So, woo! Hope you enjoy, and I'll see you soon.
Oh, Jack, where are we?
Well, we're definitely not on Earth, that's for sure.
Oh, but where are we?
I know, I've never been to this place before, but... Oh no, what's that?
Oh no, Gwen, quite bad, that's a weevil! Ah, good job, Jack.
You're welcome.
You will become like us. You must be upgraded.
Jack, what are those metal things?
They, Gwen, are called Cybermen. They are very, very dangerous.
You will be upgraded.
Ah, take this, Cybermen! Pew, pew, pew! Oh no! They're one of the Master Cybermen!
You are correct.
There's only one thing to do. Weevil, attack! I never thought I could say this, but well done, Weevil!
What's that, Jack? Is that another Cyberman?
No, Gwen. That is a Cyberwoman.
Help me.
Gwen, I won't get too close.
Don't worry, Jack. She only wants help.
That's what they all say.
Don't worry. You're safe now.
You will be upgraded. Ah!